थैंक यू वेरी मच. इट इज ए ऑनर फॉर मी टू प्रेजेंट इन दिस इंस्ट्रक्शन कोर्स. आई एम थैंकफुल टू डॉक्टर वैशाली वसावड़ा एज वेल एज डॉक्टर वसावड़ा फॉर माई एकोमोडेटिंग मी माई टॉपिक इन दिस इंस्ट्रक्शन कोर्स. माई टॉपिक इज सर्जिकल टिप्स फॉर सक्सेस ऑफ पीडियाट्रिक कैटरेक्ट सर्जरी. There are several issues. It is not a single thing that is required for success. It is extremely important that pre-operative evaluation and accurate IOL power calculation is very, very important. And in the pre-operative evaluation, you have to have a complete examination of the child, and you have to dilate the pupil, and you have to see the child under slit lamp. Sometime or many times we examine the child under anesthesia, as Dr. Vaishali Vasavada said, and I think IOL power calculation that will come subsequently. And then after, once you plan the patient for surgical procedure, meticulous surgical technique is extremely important. Surgery is not the only thing. I think it is post-operative evaluation and monitoring of the child in the follow-up period, and ultimate visual rehabilitation, such as even if you place IOL, even then you have to go for refractive correction. And many of the children, particularly unilateral cataract, those operated for unilateral cataract, they need occlusion therapy. I believe we have more than 30 year follow-up of these children. Long-term follow-up is extremely important in these cases. And this is, I think, the first, this picture shows the first picture in the first post-operative day. This is the actually, what is important is that it should be a perfect surgery, clear visual axis. And the second picture shows anterior axis and posterior axis, and in the bag, placement of IOL. The third picture is again IOL in the bag. This is about, I think, 25 to 30 years old when PMM IOL were being used. This is a pharmacia IOL that point of time, placed in the capsular bag. Primary posterior capsulotomy has been done, and it shows clear visual axis. So what are the various issues of concern in children? Child may be uncooperative for examination as well as for biometry. Several time or most of the time they may need examination under anesthesia. Another issue is that there is rapidly changing axial growth or axial length of the child, particularly in the first 2 year of life. Another important issue is that particularly unilateral cataract children, majority of them, almost 60% or so, they may be amblyopic. They may not achieve optimal vision unless they are visually rehabilitated and occlusion therapy performed. Timing of the surgery already said. Implantation of the IOL, where to implant or not, is another issue. Post-operative myopic shift is one of the extremely important issue. And there are several of the complication, including posterior capsular opacification. So we have to see these children in the post-operative period and document any of the complication and manage it. It is already said, as far as we are concerned, we operate as early as 4 to 6 weeks. Mostly at 6 weeks or so, child is okay for anesthesia. But bilateral cataract, we keep the gap. It may vary from 2 to 4 weeks operating the two eyes. Contraindication is if axial length is less than 17 millimeter, corneal diameter smaller than 9 millimeter, or if there is a anterior segment anomaly or active uveitis, these are the contraindication. The general consensus in pediatric surgeon is to implant IOL wherever possible, wherever there is no contraindication, and the acceptable age is becoming progressively younger. IOL power calculation, it is extremely important. Younger children may not cooperate for biometry. Most of the time, those who are very small children, infant, and in the first 2 years of life, we use handheld keratometer, and many a time in the operation theater. And we also take their axial length. Those children who are cooperative, we use IOL master, particularly in the older children. And this is one of the earliest guidelines by Dahan, where children less than 2 years of age, we undercorrect biometry by 20% and 2 to 8 years by 10%. Or if it is not possible, these are only the guidelines. If it is not possible to do this, then we may even take estimate from the axial length. These are such as for 17 millimeter, 28, 18, 27, or such as for 21 millimeter axial length, 22. These are the rough estimate, and by experience we know that we should not keep the child much more hypermetropic, because gross difference will also lead to a problem in the correction and amblyopia. This is some of the other study which shows that to compensate for the myopic shift till 5 years of age, according to this author, child is kept myopic, and that is kept hypermetropic, and that decreases with the as the increase in the age of the child. Very rightly, Professor Vasavade also said that it is a team which has to do the job. We need ophthalmologist, pediatrician examine the child for any systemic anomaly. Anesthetist is very important. And then optometrist also plays an extremely important role, because repeated refraction in these children. And parents, of course, is number one most important. Counseling has to be done, as already said by Dr. Vaishali. It is very, very important, because we have to explain that it is not a just one-time surgery. They have to these children has to have follow-up, and we have to also explain the various post-operative complications, various surgical procedure. What we have to choose is phaco aspiration and PC IOL implantation, particularly in older children, 8 years and older. Primary posterior capsulotomy with the anterior vitrectomy with capsular bag fixation of IOL. This is what we do in majority, over 90% of the cases. Usually 6 years and younger, we make primary posterior capsulotomy. 6 to 8 years, sometime we also judge the compliance of whether they will come for follow-up or not. But majority of the children, they come for follow-up. But if we make sometime larger posterior capsulotomy, then even we do optic capture with or without anterior vitrectomy. Lensectomy and anterior vitrectomy is done for those children where it is a micro-ophthalmia or microcornea, where IOL implantation is contraindicated. These are some of the issues. These include general anesthesia in children, elastic anterior capsule and posterior capsule, vitreous pressure, shallow anterior chamber, posterior capsulotomy, centration of the IOL, decreased scleral rigidity, and these are some of the challenging cases. There are numerous in these cases. And this is a demonstration of one of the child where we have done well-centered rexes. Ideally, rexes should be about around 5 millimeter or so. And this is a small. This is a surgical video of a child who had bilateral cataract. This is the child where we dilated. And you can see this $1 million smile of this child having bilateral cataract. And this is after dilatation. Actually, it was found to be posterior lenticonus. And here we have made side port incision and then staining the anterior capsule. In many of the cases where it is a white cataract or particularly beginner surgeon, they may also like to do the same. And here it is continuous curvilinear capsulorhexis and followed by hydro dissection and then removal of the cortex from the capsular bag. And we have to remove all the cortical material and even fibril from the capsular bag. This is this came out to be posterior.
Sir, can I request you to please conclude? It's time up, sir. Okay,
time up. Dr. Jinal, I think we have an hour to go and we are only three more speakers. So maybe we can extend by a couple of minutes. We have enough time for discussion as well.
Ma'am, actually, according to my schedule, I have 10 minutes for each doctor with discussion. So that's how I am proceeding.
Yes, but
I don't think that 10 minutes is over, but I don't have.
We have only 5 speakers. So you have a buffer of 10 minutes.
Okay, ma'am, we can do that.
Okay, thank you.
2 minutes I can add up in the timer. Thank you, ma'am.
And this is a classical case where it is a jonular type of cataract. We are placing a side port incision, particularly for younger people and those who are beginner. This is here staining of the capsule. And then this is the main incision. And this is continuous curvilinear capsulorhexis. Hydro dissection, removal of the cortex from the capsular bag. And this is after removal of the cortex from the bag, and this is anterior rexis. This will be followed by posterior continuous curvilinear capsulorhexis. Most of the time, this is with the uterata forceps, but if some time we are stuck up, we do not hesitate to use vitrectomy cutter. But here it is alone with uterata forceps. And then we place in such patient IOL in the capsular bag. Almost 100% of the cases we use hydrophobic acrylic IOL. And most of the time it is single piece, but some of the time it may be 3-piece IOL. But the single piece IOL should not be placed in the sulcus. And this is occlusion therapy. It is very, very critical, particularly for the management of amblyopia. And these are some of the cases where microphthalmia or some other problem or some older days, these glasses are used, abnormal size of the spectacle frames. And surgery is just the first step and the follow-up is extremely important. You have to examine the child very, very carefully. Most importantly, the word of the illness are worth remembering. Young children with an IOL in place are the unique clinical responsibility of an ophthalmologist, and long-term follow-up is especially important. We have follow-up of 30-35 years of these children. Next. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. That was excellent. So comprehensive and wonderful surgical tips. It makes surgery look so easy when we see your videos all the time.
We also see surge video and your video, that is not less. I think you people do excellent surgery. We are impressed by surgical procedure, which we learned from sir, whatever.
No, sir, those perfectly centered CCCs and PCCs and of such a large size, it's really amazing.
Thank you so much.
I think Professor Jagatram has told and taught us how to do the cataract surgery in children. And he rightly emphasized that surgeon is an important part of the game, but not the only one. The parents, he said, is the most important part. And follow-up, you remember, he keeps telling 30 years of follow-up and so on. So it's a lifetime commitment. Once you take a child, a cataract, for cataract surgery, whatever you do, keep following up. And we are going to listen in the previous to last presentation, how what they do in the follow-up and so on. So I think this is excellent. Okay.
I have one question before we move on. I would like each panelist to give just a brief one-line response. What is your cutoff age for performing a vitrectomy, anterior vitrectomy for a pediatric cataract? In an otherwise normal child who can generally cooperate for a yard or something?
Usually, I do up to 6 years of age, but that is not the exclusive. Sometimes those children who have posterior lenticonus or posterior polar, or these may extend even beyond 6 years. But by and large, after 6 years, many of the children, they cooperate for ND, yard laser, capsulotomy. So younger children, less than 6 years or less, we do primary posterior capsulotomy and anterior vitrectomy.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Sumita?
I think,
you can go ahead.
No, Sunita, go ahead. We want to listen from Sunita.
Then Varshini, in that case, we move on to you.
So 6 to 7 years usually in normal cataracts, but in traumatic cataracts, still older if the PC is thickened, especially.
Yeah, I think most of us do the same as Professor Jagatram said, you know.
Okay.
I think 8 years is what we do, anterior vitrectomy, and I do for every child who has nystagmus also, because it's very difficult to yag them. So yes. The children have nystagmus and traumatic cataract, I do for everyone. Even irrespective of age.
So I think the idea of everybody has highlighted this, that you, unless we manage the posterior capsule and the anterior vitreous, it is really mostly no point doing the cataract surgery, especially for younger children. So that is something which we must realize. And just doing a posterior capsule or excis, if you're not capturing the IOL in a younger child, again, brings you back almost to the same situation.